Hi, I'm Chad with Mastercam. If you're like me, you're always looking for new ways to be efficient when programming CNC machines. One of the best ways to save your time and your machine operator's time is to reuse previously defined Mastercam tools that are already in the machine on the shop floor. Of course, you first need to check that these tools are suitable for the new project. A new feature in Mastercam 2021 called Check Tool Reach makes quick work of this task. Let's say, for example, that we're in the process of quoting this Formula SAE upright. My 5-axis machine is still set up from a previous project, and I want to check if a specific tool is capable of machining the deep pockets in the square bracket on the lower right corner of the upright. In this case, the Formula SAE team is allowing us to propose minor design changes to make the part more manufacturable. On the Toolpaths tab, let's open Check Tool Reach. Check Tool Reach is a utility that does more than check if the cutting tool's projection relative to the tool holder is long enough. It also checks the effectiveness of the tool's corner radius against the model. First, we need to set the upright as the target. We can manually define a generic tool here, or we can select a fully defined library tool. First, let's check how much of the part we can reach with tool number 2. Instead of a generic holder, I'd like to use the holder as defined in the tool assembly, so let's toggle that option on. Click Preview to see the results, but don't click OK yet. To see the result more clearly, we can save the results as a mesh. On the Advanced tab, select a new level for the mesh to be output on, and say Level 2. On the Basic tab, check Create Polygonal Mesh and click OK. Now we can turn off Level 1 to see the results. Check Tool Reach is performed from your current C-plane. The blue color shows us the area that is reachable with the selected tool. The red color shows areas that this tool can't reach due to a tool collision. Any brown areas would signify areas that are unreachable due to a holder collision. It appears that there are no holder collisions with tool number 2, however, there are plenty of red areas. In fact, the whole lower pocket of our target area is red. This shows us, without having to measure or program anything, that the tool is too large to machine this pocket. We can also see that the fillet radii around the part are unreachable with this large of a tool. Another tool that I'd like to test is tool number 15. Double-click the Part and Fixture view sheet to reset the graphics view and open Check Tool Reach again. Once more, set the target as our part. Activate Create P-Mesh and select Tool 15 from the library. Activate the Use Holder option and define Level 3 as the output level. Click Preview to generate the geometry and click OK. Now let's turn on Level 3 and turn off Level 1. We now see brown areas showing holder collisions. However, most of the feature that we want to machine is shown in blue as reachable, except for the corner fillets. Also, this flat area between the floor fillets is too narrow for the flat portion of the bullnose end mill to fit between. So now that we have a better idea of how our existing tooling is going to work for this part, let's propose some minor changes to the model. Copy the model to level 10 and make sure to turn off level 1. On the Model Prep tab, select Modify Fillet. Control-click one of these fillets to select them all. Let's resize them all to a radius of 0.0625 inches. One final time, open Check Tool Reach and set the modified part as the target. Select Tool 15, use the holder from the tool assembly, and click Preview. Instead of saving to a mesh again, we can toggle wireframe shading to see the results more clearly. We can now be sure that Tool 15 will be able to successfully reach this entire feature. We didn't need to analyze any geometry or create a single toolpath. It's possible that this sort of task can now be performed by a less skilled Mastercam user, saving the programmer even more time. Even if the programmer must run this check themselves, it is an extremely fast way to help determine what programming strategy to pursue.